Hey everybody, Jake here, and welcome to the hobby. Like the title says, I actually sold some Pokemon cards. You know, I rarely sell cards, but it does happen every now and again when I feel like I need to downsize my collection and buy some other stuff with the extra money. So I wanted to share with you guys some of the items that I sold, what I sold them for, and what the profit margins on some of these products are. A lot of this stuff I sold directly on eBay, Mercari, and a couple of these were private sales, so take it with a grain of salt if you don't believe me or something like that. That's totally cool. I'm just here shouting out random numbers. So what can we say? Let's go over some of the items that I sold. First item up, we have a Sun and Moon Burning Shadows booster box. Sold two copies of these. Really fantastic set. I have five of these Burning Shadows booster box inside of my collection, which is quite a bit. Most of my sealed products, I don't have a lot of copies of, but this one I happen to have five copies and I felt like it was just too many. I didn't need five. If we ever want to open up one or two on the channel, I would have some couple of extras. So I sold two copies of Burning Shadows booster boxes. The selling price on these were $400, so $800 total. And after my cost of purchasing these booster boxes, I bought each of these for $140, all that yada yada. Total cost was $350 with a profit of $450. Next item up, we sold a Mario Pikachu Luigi box. Yes, that is sort of like the official name. Kind of an interesting box. I have one of these in the back display all the time. This is an extra copy. I had a couple of these left, so I decided to sell one of these for $2,000. My cost on this box was $240. That was the price that I purchased it originally as. And after eBay costs and all that, our profit is $1,600. And I'm sure you're gonna say, oh, Jake, that's just the one from the background. No, it's not. I really do have extra copies of these. So take that one, commenter. Next up, we're gonna show you guys some graded Pokemon cards that I've sold. Sold a Shibuya Pikachu card, PSA 10. I have a lot of copies of these. Just made sense to downsize my collection a little bit. The selling price on this card was $325. This one sold directly on my eBay account. I will have a link down in the description to my eBay account if you guys wanna see it. I'll be honest, it's really dry. I have like nothing for sale. Very rarely do I list cards, but I like to be transparent. So if you want to see my eBay store, you can find it. It's not hidden in any way. If you guys want to see it, you can see it. I know there's some YouTubers out there that do not show their eBay stores, and I thought, why not? That just seems like a weird thing to hide. So yeah, it definitely exists. Sold this card for $325, and the cost on this card were literal pennies. I bought this card originally for $5, spent $10 grading it after eBay fees and whatnot. The profit on this card was $280. Next up, we have ourselves an Easter Pikachu. Sold a copy of this card in a PSA 9. Selling price on this card was $300, which was actually really shocking to me because I'll be honest, PSA 9 usually don't go for that high of a price. So it was surprising. Great card, honestly. I really like this card. It's the only Easter themed card in Pokemon. So if you want something Easter themed, this is pretty much it. After total cost of $55, the profit on this card was $245. So the great thing about eBay is that if you can sell enough cards or sell enough volume, you eventually no longer need to use PayPal. And if you don't use PayPal, the profit margins are definitely a little bit better. Sold a lot of copies of the Stained Glass Bird. This was one of my hottest pick from 2019. I knew this card would do really well, and I have a bunch of these cards because I open up a bunch of Hidden Fates Elite Trainer boxes for the channel. And really fantastic graded card, a very easy grade, honestly. You can get PSA 10 copies of these surprisingly easy. Although if you don't want to do the wait, it's honestly, you know, just pick one up. Sold six copies of the Stained Glass Bird. Each one sold for right around $130 or so. My total cost on this card, all six copies combined, was $180. The profit is $600 because it's six copies of this card. So $100 profit per card. Not too shabby. Next up, we have Afro Pikachu. I bought three copies of the of this exact card originally from Mr. SM Pratt himself. Really great card. I bought each copy for $30 and this one I sold for $300. So talk about a return on investment, right? That what is that, like a 900% return on investment? Pretty darn insane. Total cost on this card was $55, including eBay fees and whatnot, so a profit of $245. I rounded the numbers a little bit to make them nice and easy for me to calculate in this video, but this is very close to the actual selling price. We have a complete set of Victory Medal, first place, second place, and third place. This is a really great pseudo trophy set. If you're looking for something that's more affordable inside of your collection, these will look fantastic on display. I sold a set of these for $1,000. The grading cost and purchasing cost for me and eBay selling fee and all that combined was $180. So the profit margin on this was $820 for this set. And now we're moving on to some of the big ticket item. The first big ticket item that I sold, I would say, is the PSA 10 Scream Pikachu promo. This is the last copy I'm selling. I'm not selling any more copies of this card. I don't have any more to really sell. I have some more copies, but they're mine. I don't want anyone else having them. So what did I sell this card for? I sold a copy of this card for $1,800. And yeah, the profit margin on this card is insane because I'll be honest, I got in this card very early on. I purchased this card for $40. The cost of grading is $10. The eBay fee was actually the hardest hit part. The eBay fees were $150. So total cost on this card was $200 for a profit of $1,600. So really, really fantastic profit margin. And you guys are probably thinking like, oh Jake, you made an absolute killing. And I did on this specific card. However, I'm gonna tell you guys a massive burn, okay? I have sold three copies of the Pikachu PSA 10 Scream promo for $100. $100, guys, sold three copies of them. This was around a year and a half ago, and that was the market value price on this card at the time, so don't fully regret it. But now we're moving on to the biggest items that I've sold in quite a while, and I don't think I'm gonna sell anything of this caliber again in the near future. I do have some more high value cards for sure, but you know, a lot of it I want to keep inside of my collection, so this is probably like the last big selling item that I'm gonna do for quite a while. Last big ticket item, I sold a complete set of PSA 10 Mario Pikachu. We got the mini one, the full art one, and of course the same with Luigi. Sold a complete set of these to a private collector. We did it outside of eBay, which can be a little bit sketchy, but I know who the buyer was and they are very reputable, so I knew that it was legitimate. The whole entire set I sold for $6,000. My initial cost for this set was $700. Luckily, I didn't have to go through eBay. If I went through eBay, it would have been a little bit more transparent and secure, but it would have cost me an extra $600 onto my profit margin. So the net profit on these cards for me is right around $5,300, a really fantastic set. This is my final set of completed Mario Pikachu, so I'm not selling this set. This is my personal copy, it's gonna be in my collection. I have a couple of extra boxes that I could crack open and grade those cards, but honestly, it's a little bit risky, you know? You can't really tell if the cards inside are gonna be of any better quality than the ones on the open market. The promo cards inside of the boxes might not be mint, so there are some serious risks to grading the cards from inside of the box themselves. Like if I crack this box open, the cards inside are not guaranteed to be minty fresh, and I'll be honest, grading fees are very, very expensive right now, so it is a serious amount of risk. There's some rewards and upside, but definitely some serious risk, especially if those cards come back as like PSA 8s or whatnot. You're actually in the hole rather than making any money. So yeah, really fantastic cards. Most of these I've had in my collections for years. That's why the profit margins on these can seem a little bit exorbitant at certain times. A lot of these I purchased, you know, a long time ago, so definitely have seen some serious value gains and really nice solid piece of profit. A lot of that money is going to go right back into Pokemon or other hobbies that I have. So yeah, those are some of the big items that I've been currently having sold. And honestly, it's a lot of fun selling some stuff as well. It's really refreshing to clean up some of my collection. And it's nice to have some money in the bank where I can actually use it to buy a couple more collectibles. And if we absolutely buy some cool collectibles, I will definitely share with you guys what those purchases are. Thank you so much for watching. I hope this has been insightful. A lot of people talk about like, hey, how do you divide up like the cost, price, and profits on selling Pokemon cards and whatnot? And honestly, all of it is very straightforward. In this e-commerce day and age, you can sell stuff within hours or minutes super easily on just about any website. If you have a phone, you can do it too. That's pretty much it from me. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you guys next time.